we've chosen a different path forward than the E3 has with respect to the JCPOA. That's been public for an awfully long time. Our view is this. Our view is to isolate Iran, to put pressure on the Iranian regime, to deny them resources, to foment terror in Lebanon through Hezbollah or in the Gaza Strip through Hamas and the PIJ, or the Iraqi militia, the Shia militias in Iraq. That's how we will ultimately convince the Iranian regime to change its behavior and provide an opportunity for the Iranian people to get the government that I know that they want. That's our theory. The theory of the case that the E3 had is a different one. They think the JCPOA best serves that. That's been a sharp disagreement. That hasn't changed. But we have been very pleased. The E3 executed or notified of the dispute resolution mechanism. That's a good step forward. We think that's positive. We hope that as we approach this big demarcation that occurs in October, the very missiles that put American lives at risk in Iraq and the very missiles that fell on Saudi Aramco can be lawfully sold by China or Russia to Iran come October of this year. This is consistent with the JCPOA. This is the fundamental failing. Iran will be free to buy conventional weapon systems from any willing seller come October of this year, just a handful of years after this ridiculous nuclear deal was signed. We're aiming to get that extended. We're aiming to get it fixed. It is important. It's important not just for the United States, but for European countries as well.